4. Man City 2-3 Man United. Pogba and co. shut down City's party. Manchester City's title celebrations were put on hold after Paul Pogba inspired a second-half comeback for Manchester United in a thrilling derby. Manchester United produced an incredible second-half comeback to beat rivals Manchester City 3-2 and leave them waiting for confirmation of the Premier League title after a thrilling game at the Etihad Stadium. Pep Guardiola's side seemed to be cruising to the crown as they went in at the break with a 2-0 lead. But United conjured an extraordinary response led by two-goal Paul Pogba and crowned by Chris Smalling's winner. After 25 minutes, City took what seemed to be their first step towards confirming the title when captain Vincent Kompany rose unmarked to thump home a header. And 5 minutes later it appeared all but in the bag as Ilkay Gundogan scored in style. Raheem Sterling twice fired over from good positions, but after 53 minutes United were back in it with a high-quality goal. Alexis Sanchez picking at Ander Herrera, who chested the ball down for Pogba to clip home, and within 2 minutes they had made it 2-2. Again the goal was excellent and again Sanchez was involved, flighting in a perfect cross for Pogba to head past Ederson. Astonishingly, after 69 minutes United were in front. Sanchez again the provider as his deep free kick from the left was met by Smalling, who escaped his markers to thump past Ederson, and City could not find a way back. Everton and Liverpool had to settle for a share of the spoils as the Merseyside derby ended in a 0-0 stalemate at Goodison Park. Both keepers made outstanding contributions to a bitty match. Jordan Pickford getting in the way of a close-range Dominic Solanke strike before Loris Karius produced a superb fingertip save when Yannick Bolasie curled a shot from the edge of the box. Another fine stop from Pickford followed on the half-hour as Milner cut in and saw his effort, heading for the far corner, tipped away. The second half produced little in the way of incident, but with 4 minutes to go Everton were within a whisker of winning as CNC Tosin's header drifted wide and then Dominic Calvert-Lewin fired off target. Tottenham Hotspur secured 3 more points as a hard-fought 2-1 win at Stoke City plunged their hosts deeper into trouble. After a scrappy start Stoke should have led when Mbram Diouf failed to capitalize on Ramadan Sobi cross. And after 23 minutes it was Spurs' turn to go close when Jack Butland denied Sun Heung-min. The visitors needed only 10 minutes of the second half to go in front as Del Ali set up Christian Eriksen, only for Stoke to bounce back when Hugo Lloris hit a clearance at Diouf, who took full advantage. Eriksen then whipped in a dangerous free kick that found its way into the corner to seal the win. But Jordan Shaqiri crashed an effort against the post as Paul Lambert's side kept battling. Brighton and Huddersfield took a point apiece after 2 first-half strikes brought a 1-1 draw between two sides fighting to stay clear of danger at the Amex. The Seagulls should have led in the opening moments when Davy Proper clean through, shot past the post, and in an open start home keeper Matt Ryan stopped Steve Morney's shot. Chris Hughton's side regained their composure and took the lead after 29 minutes when Solly Mocha's shot was tipped onto the post by Losel and the ball rebounded in off the keeper. But Huddersfield were level minutes later when Shane Duffy's loose back pass was seized on by Mooney. Brighton went down to 10 men with 15 minutes remaining as Proper was shown a straight red for a challenge on Jonathan Hogg. But Jose Izquierdo could have won it for Albion only for Losel to deny him in a one-on-one. Bournemouth twice came back from a goal down to draw 2-2 at home to relegation-threatened Crystal Palace. An early chance came and went for the Cherries as Callum Wilson miscontrolled when a better touch would have put him through. Wilson then volleyed over, but Palace made the breakthrough 2 minutes into the second half as Luka Milivojevic curled a free kick into the corner, and could have added another when Patrick Van Aanholt had an effort blocked. Bournemouth were level after 65 minutes when substitute Lys Mousset struck with a low finish moments after coming on, but Palace took the lead again when Wilfried Zaha's strike was deflected in before the hosts salvaged an 89th minute point through another substitute, Josh King. Newcastle are on the brink of Premier League safety after a 2-1 win at Leicester City. The visitors made a high-powered start and Kasper Schmeichel kept out an Ios Perez header from a corner, with Dwight Gayle looping a header too close to the keeper soon afterwards. They took a deserved lead after 18 minutes when Jonjo Shelvey was found by Perez just outside the area and cut inside before firing home a low finish. Leicester had appeals for a penalty turned down when Riyad Mahrez seemed to be brought down by Paul Dummett, but Perez clipped a stunning finish over Schmeichel to double the lead and, despite Jamie Vardy pulling one back, Newcastle held on. Burnley kept their excellent recent run going as they came from a goal down to win 2-1 at Watford. The Clarets thought they had taken an early lead when Chris Wood's header was ruled out for offside, and Ashley Barnes glanced over his Sean Dyche's side made an excellent start. Watford came back into the game, Troy Deeney sending an effort wide and Will Hughes drawing a good save from Nick Pope, with the visiting keeper also doing well to deny Roberto Pereira. Pereira collected a loose ball and shot past Pope soon after the hour, but substitute Sam Vokes took advantage of poor defending to level and Jack Cork quickly put the Clarets in front when his header crossed the line before being clawed out. West Brom ended their 8-game losing streak with a 1-1 draw at home to Swansea City. The Baggies, all but relegated, made a decent start in front of a subdued crowd and Jay Rodriguez had an attempt blocked and saw another saved by Lukasz Fabianski. They continued their positive approach after the break and grabbed the lead after 54 minutes when Rodriguez made it third time lucky, but Swansea, sliding back towards danger, responded when Tammy Abraham turned home the leveler with 15 minutes left.